Yam is a major staple food and source of income for over 60 million people in Africa. It has a major production constraint, as farmers often use leftover yam, mostly taken from deceased yams, as planting materials, thereby reducing yield. Dr. Chris Okonkwo demonstrates how to produce seed yam using minisets technology in different stages.
Farmers normally keep one-third of their previous seeds for the next year's production. But the problem with that system is that they keep seeds, very small seeds that are resulting from plant diseases, because after selection, tubers that are not big enough to be eaten or sold are kept for production of the next season. To arrest that trend, we want to teach what is called minisets techniques. And to produce seeds using minisets technique, we have several stages. The first stage is selection of mother seed yams. Mother seed yams are yams weighing between 500 to 1 kilogram. You need to use this size because using a bigger size will result in wastage of the flesh. The healthy mother seed yam should be free from diseases. It should also have broken dormancy. The sign of dormancy is when you see that it is sprouting, like the one I'm having, or this. Yams with infections such as this, nematode, should not be used for mother seed yams, because the buds or the eye on the skin of the yams, from where they will sprout or germinate from, have been destroyed by the nematodes. So also, yams that are infested with scale insects should not be used. The skins and the buds of the yam tuber has also been damaged by the insects. They will not sprout. Rather, you will be distributing the pest in your farm. After the selection of mother seed yams, the next stage is cutting the tubers into minisets. The tools required are your sharp knife, your disinfectant, which could be either insecticide or a mixture of fungicide and insecticide, the tubers, and the cutting surface. In cutting the mother seed, and the first thing is to cut the cross section. The size of the place containing the bark, where the eyes are, where the yams will germinate from, should be about 6 cm by 6 cm. For farmers who don't understand measurement, they can use a matchbox to get the cross section of the yam. After cutting the cross section of the yam, then you cut longitudinally. We can cut this size into four cross sections. If you measure this, it will be about the size of a matchbox or 6 cm square, because that's where the sprouts will come from. This is how to cut minisets. The size of minisets can vary from 25 grams up to 50 grams, depending on the yam being cut and the technical expert of the person doing the cutting. After cutting the miniset, the next stage is treating the cut surfaces. The cut surfaces can be treated with insecticides, fungicides, a mixture of both. Where you cannot afford it, ordinary wood ash can be used. The materials required at this stage is the cut materials, the chemicals, the wood ash, water in case you're using suspension, basket, and then hand gloves to avoid the direct contact of chemical with your skin. The cut surfaces can be treated by dabbing the cut surfaces with the wood ash and a mixture of fungicide, or you treat with a suspension of the chemicals and wood ash. Use suspension of the chemical and wood ash to treat the materials. The materials are put into a basket and then dipped in the solution for about 5 to 10 minutes. You allow the water to drain from the basket before going to dry the materials under shade.